While I've been stuck at home like the rest of the world, things have actually been extremely productive here on my end. I've been streamlining my workflows, learning new things, aprendo español y montar mi bicicleta. I think I got that right, learning Spanish and riding my bike. True story, when I'm not working, filming videos, or playing games, I've actually been out and about riding my bike all over the place. I got so into biking again these past few weeks that I actually bought myself a new foldable bike, and it's called the Zizzo Urbano. I knew nothing about this bike. I just read a ton of reviews on it online, and from what I gathered, it seemed like an excellent, affordable, foldable bike. So, Ray being Ray, I took a $330 chance on it. I figured I would get more use out of spending the extra money on a foldable bike that I could just pop in my trunk and take with me anywhere that I go. It's been about 2 weeks now, and I logged about 50 miles on this thing, no exaggeration. What is up, my friends? It's Ray back here, and today we're going to be doing something a little bit different than normal. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Zizzo Urbano foldable bike. This is an extremely lightweight 24-pound 8-speed bike with 20-inch wheels, a comfortable plushy seat, and a solid aluminum folding frame that allows you to open and close the bike in literally less than 30 seconds. The Urbano is an excellent bike that I can confidently say so far is a steal of a deal for what you're getting for the price. Here on the channel, you guys know I don't talk about products that I don't believe in, and this here was one of those really, really good buys. Bear in mind that since this whole quarantine started, bicycles, including the Urbano, have become one of those really hard to come by items since everyone is looking to get outdoors and for something to do. While this thing did take a week and a half to come in the mail, the plus side is that it does come pre-assembled, so there's no assembly required, just unfold it and start riding. Anyway, before we continue on, I wanted to remind you guys to smash that subscribe button and hit that bell notification icon so you can be notified by YouTube whenever I decide to live stream and upload new videos. There is so much content coming down the pipeline that I don't want you guys to miss a thing. Every sub, every thumbs up, everything helps support the channel, so let's grow together, and without further ado, let's get outside and do some riding. So I think what surprised me the most about this bike was how well it rides and how well it glides in a variety of different scenarios. I've been on dirt trails, on paths in the park, on streets, on sidewalks, no matter what was beneath it, this thing handled it with ease. I was really surprised at how versatile it is and how well it performs on a variety of different surfaces. Given its name, the Urbano is clearly built towards urban commuting and fun riding, so don't expect to be climbing mountains or anything like that. In fact, unless you're going fast, this thing does struggle a bit when you're going up hills. The bike itself also looks pretty sweet. It gives off that minimal urban European vibe, which is something that I am a huge fan of. Also, don't be like Ray, you should definitely wear a helmet. I'm waiting on mine to come in the mail, so little disclaimer here, wear a helmet when you're riding a bike. As I mentioned briefly before, this is an 8-speed bike, so you can catch some serious speed on this little guy. The Urbano uses a genuine 8-speed Shimano gearing system that shifts effortlessly between the first gear all the way up to the 8th gear. When you're riding it, the transitions are very, very smooth. The handling on this bike is also spot on and very responsive. You can stop on a dime, turn in a second, and as far as overall handling goes, it's just hard for me to find a complaint with how the Urbano performs, especially for the price. When it comes to adjusting the bike and folding it up, things are dead simple. I showcased earlier that you can get up and running in less than 30 seconds, and that is no exaggeration. Everything here is lever-based, so you can snap open the levers when you're folding the bike up, and snap close the levers when you're setting things up. This also remains true for the handles and for the seat. Regardless of how you have it, the bike still remains 24 pounds, so it can easily be picked up with just one hand to lift it up a curb or to toss it in your trunk. It is worth mentioning that for such a lightweight bike, the max weight here is 240 pounds, so there's a lot of flexibility here, and it can be appealing to many people out there. I'm a 5'10 dude, about 155 pounds, and I find the Urbano to be the perfect size for me. I mean, you guys could be the judge. Does it look too small? Does it look too big? I don't know. But before we wrap up this video though, let's go outside again and toss this thing in my trunk so you guys can see how it fits and how I've been traveling around with it. Let's take a look.
Woo! So here it is, guys, the Zizzo Urbano folded up here in the trunk of my Audi A3. As you can see, guys, this thing fits like a glove. Like, I couldn't ask for a better size foldable bike for this trunk.
because there's not that much room remaining. The reason why I use this blanket here is because there's a little bolt that sticks up and I don't want it to scratch the ceiling of my trunk or anything like that. I also use this Velcro strap that came with the bike when it actually shipped and I took it out of the box. It keeps the tires together and it keeps them from having a mind of their own and basically just going and doing their own thing. But yeah, guys, as you can see, I've been taking this thing everywhere. It's a little bit dirty on dirt trails and things like that. And honestly, for the price, I couldn't ask for a better foldable bike. For my needs, for traveling, for commuting, the Zizzo Urbano is great. It just slides right in your trunk, folds up very small, and I can't help but recommend it. Anywho, that's about it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it and found it helpful. If you did, you know the drill by now. Be sure to give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button because it always helps out the channel. And until the next one, I'll catch you guys later. Stay safe out there. Peace!